My name is Lisa Harrington. I live in La Porte, Texas. When I look down at my feet, all I see is ugly. And I just want to tuck my foot right behind me because I can't wear the closed-toed shoes that much because of the pain. So I wear open-toed shoes a lot, and people look at it all the time. I see them, and I'm very self-conscious of it.
Hey, sister. Hey,
how you been?
I'm doing good. You doing all
right? Good, yeah, I'm doing good.
Good to see you.
It's good to see you, too.
Would you like to have a glass of wine?
Oh, I would.
Lisa's feet are really bad, and she's in pain every day. But she just keeps going. She refuses to sit down and just not do the things that she wants to do in life.
We're gonna just trim your bangs today, or
I want you to look at it and see if you think it needs thinning too.
I was a hairdresser for 30 years. Stood on my feet for 30 years.
Okay, awesome.
All right, that looks good. I love being a hairdresser, but my foot issues actually started about 7 years ago. My feet took my passion for hair away. Standing at the salon 10 and 12 hours a day, I couldn't handle the pain anymore. I had to close my salon.
How are your feet doing?
Oh, they're not doing good at all.
Well, I will be so glad when you can get that fixed.
It is definitely time for Lisa to put herself first and get her feet fixed and healed. And we're all gonna be there for her during that process. She deserves it.
I know you don't like to complain about it, but I know you're in a lot of pain. Your feet are stopping you, you know, trying to stop you.
Yes.
From living your life that you want to live.
I feel the more I walk on it, the worse it gets. My left foot is the worst foot.
Exactly. Oh, it's getting worse, girl.
That big toe started moving in first. That second toe started to cross over, and then finally, it was totally crossed. I always tell everybody, I got my toes crossed for you, so all right. This is right where it hurts, right in that ball, right there. This toe is just dead. I can move it all around. But when it hurts is when this rubs against the shoes.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. This toe here is starting to cross over this big toe, and it rubs on that big toe now. I have tried to go to a doctor to get it fixed, you know, before it got bad, but my insurance wouldn't cover it, so it's gotten worse. What I forgot to tell you was I had an interview with the doctor out in California, and she thinks she can fix it.
Both feet?
Yes.
Oh.
But I'm going to have to go to California.
Well, that's gonna be great when you get your feet fixed.
I'll be able to walk farther, stand longer.
And be out of pain.
I tell you, sister.
I have a patient, she's coming in today. Her name is Lisa, and she has quite a big bunion. One that's actually affected her second toe too, which is actually going over the big toe. So anytime you have dislocated joints or bunions or hammer toes or any other foot deformity, you can't put enough weight on that surface. So the rest of the foot takes the weight-bearing brunt. So not only do you have one thing going wrong, it's kind of a domino effect.
Hi.
I'm gonna try and figure out how best I can help her because her feet are in very bad condition. I see bunions that have the overlapping toe, but I've never seen it where it was like the whole first toe was touching the third toe. That was pretty impressive.
So
This is the main culprit.
That doesn't hurt. Where it hurts is on the bottom of that, right in there.
Right in there?
Right in there.
I hear you. What about the second toe?
The second toe only hurts when I wear closed-toed shoes and it rubs on that.
That top area?
And it hurts bad.
You have what's called metatarsalgia, where the heads of the metatarsal bones are more plantar flexed than upright. Every step, you're putting more pressure right on the ball of your foot.
Yeah.
So we definitely want to fix it here and then address the cosmetic portion a little bit,
okay?
Because this bone should be sitting on top of this metatarsal bone, which is right here. Let me go ahead and describe to you what I believe needs to happen. We're gonna fix your bunion, which is your biggest issue mm-hmm. with this. And then we're gonna realign the joint and straighten out this toe joint.
Okay.
All right.
That sounds great. Okay.
Think it's gonna mess up her tattoo?
I could probably miss your tattoo. That's a nice one.
Thank you, that's my mom. She's been gone for 14 years now.
And yeah, I'm gonna try my best, okay?
Okay.
To not ruin the tattoo.
Don't not do the best you can do.
For this to save the tattoo,
fix the foot, then not save the tattoo.
Right. Got it. And then the last thing we're gonna do is on this foot, we're gonna straighten out this toe here.
Great.
Just so you know, doing both feet at the same time is a little challenging because you don't really have one side to lean on.
Right.
You know.
Yeah.
So, but you've got some help.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
So we're all gonna work it out.
The hardest part for me is, I'm not used to asking for help. And I'm having to ask for help now. I don't do that.
Okay.
Well, I know
it's not gonna be a walk in the park.
Right.
Foot surgery is tough to recover from, but you know, I'm with you every step of the way. So I will see you the day of surgery.
Yes.
And take care.
Thank you, Dr. Ebony.
Bye-bye.
Today is my surgery. I'm feeling nervous. I'm ready to go through with this, but my insides are going crazy. So I've just been sitting here breathing.
Well, hello,
Dr. Ebony, how are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm doing good, just a little anxious.
That's totally normal.
I know.
Anyone who's going under for surgery, if they feel completely calm, I would be worried more then.
Right, exactly.
Let's go over everything slowly and in detail, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna mark both of your feet because we're doing both.
Yes.
So let me just take a look at your feetsies here and describe what we're doing to each, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so this is the one that has the most work.
This one's the one that's gonna give you your...
I know,
you're gonna give me a run for my money here
for this one.
Yes.
All right, so we're gonna fix the bunion, all right? Basically, your bone is turned all the way this way.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna stabilize this joint back here. So we're gonna basically rotate this bone there, and this should kick right on out.
Okay.
Okay? The second thing we're gonna do is work on this joint here.
Okay.
All right, second foot we're gonna do is the right foot. So not only does this joint need some tending to, this one does too.
Right.
So you'll have a straighter toe without all the knots in here, okay?
And be normal. Yes.
All righty, you are in good hands. I will talk to you after surgery, then I'll see you next week.
Okay, sweetie.
Okay,
Dr. Ebony, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hello.
Lisa. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing good.
How do you feel?
I feel wonderful.
You're basically only 8 weeks out right now.
I tried to follow your orders, you know.
So you didn't weight bear?
No.
At all?
Not until you told me to.
Excellent. I'm excited to take a look.
I know.
Okay. Both of her feet hurt. One foot was very bad and one foot was kind of bad. So we fixed them both. And I'm excited to see how she has been recovering. Looks good there.
It feels good. It doesn't hurt.
Good. This one's looking good, too.
Yeah.
It doesn't cross over anymore.
I know. Yay.
When I look down and I see that my toes aren't crossed anymore, I'm just like, yes. And there's no pain. And I can walk.
All right, so things are looking great.
I just feel like back to my normal self again. I'm wearing shoes that I haven't been able to wear in a long time. Lisa is back, for sure.